Hey there, YouTubers. Just me, Ted1969 here, and we're looking at a victim of planned obsolescence, and that's in a bicycle pump that I use to keep my bike tires going. It was a bit of an inconvenience for me the day that it occurred, but I did have some other pumps here which I was able to use to get myself through the day. And basically, what it is it's a lever that you need to rotate 90 degrees. So that your pump head grips onto the valve stem, and then you can actually start pumping air into the tire. Why I liked the pump that I had was it actually fits both the Presta and Schrader valves with just some minor modifications, and everything was going good. I've had the pump for about 5 or 6 years, and some people might say it's not all that expensive of a pump, and why not buy a new one after all that time? But actually, the question that to me should be the better question is, why should you have to buy a new one? So as you can see, this piece here went where this screw is now, and like that. So when you have the pump onto the valve stem and everything's ready to go, you just lift it up and the mechanism here rotates upward, and then you can start pumping air, and I guess that's the valve or whatever for the pump. So anyway, what I did is I originally had another piece that I kind of just it was the old-fashioned style of attachment from another pump that I had, and it was a small just the Schrader head on the on a smaller flexible hose, which I just kind of joined up with a ring clamp, and I had that working. But then I kind of decided, is there anything else I could do? So I had tried to do something with epoxy, which didn't work out too well. So I can see some residue of epoxy on this broken piece here. I thought I could maybe epoxy a metal piece onto here and onto the flat part here, and maybe that would hold, but it didn't do very good, and I didn't think it would, but it was worth a try since I was lazy that day. In the end, what I had to do, I'm sick today, but I always feel better when I'm trying to fix things when I'm sick. So I made a little mistake, which is usually why I shouldn't fix things when I'm not feeling well. I actually drilled here, which is the wrong way to drill. So then I realized my mistake, and I drilled into the face down here. And fortunately, I was enough to get enough of drilling into there to get this screw in here. And of course, when you're going into plastic like this, or wood or anything, you should always use the smallest drill bit you have, make a pilot hole, and then drill about two or three consecutively larger holes, allowing that the drill the final drill bit that you use should be slightly larger than the actual screw, so that it lets the threads get in and do their thing. So I didn't drill it perfectly straight. As you can see, the screw actually rests at something of an angle. But the important thing is, now I can do the rotation again, and everything works as advertised. So back to normal with the pump, and it should be good to go. And again, I can always just swap that out by just unscrewing this and giving it just basically you have to reverse the mechanism inside, and then you can go with the Presta head for my road bike. But for my mountain bike that I'm using through the winter, that's great. So now I don't have to buy a new pump, and I was able to repair it using all stuff that I had here. I just thought I'd share this video with everyone, just in case they're ever experiencing problems with that, because my big pet peeve lately is this whole planned obsolescence thing, and I'm a big proponent of fixing what you have with parts that you have. So hopefully somebody somewhere gets something out of this, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave me a comment. Thank you very much. Have a great day.